On today's episode, space-based 5G networks, the end of cellular. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. The combination of handheld devices and the emergence of the Internet of Things has created an unprecedented demand for high-speed, low-latency data transfer. 5G delivers the speed needed for live streaming of video and other data-rich applications, but future services such as connected autonomous vehicles promise to flood 5G systems with information. According to Nokia, connected self-driving cars will generate about 5 terabytes of data per hour, and other IoT devices will generate similar streams. Now, handling that wireless traffic from space-based systems seems like an obvious solution, but technical challenges are difficult. Elon Musk's Starlink system of low Earth orbit satellites is providing service, but with complex ground receiver technology that must hand off signals to satellites that are rising from and setting below the local horizon. Geosynchronous satellites offer global coverage from as few as 3 satellites, but with latency issues derived from orbits 22,000 miles high. For high-speed 5G service, Barcelona-based Satelliot has launched a prototype satellite designed to provide orbital 5G service that is interlinked with ground-based cell networks and operates with standard 5G handheld devices with no special receiving equipment. The company calls the satellite Groundbreaker, and it represents the first of 250 nanosats operating at a 300-mile altitude to provide global coverage. The system is designed primarily for commercial and industrial Internet of Things applications, although the firm notes that the system is capable of greatly extending the coverage area of current 5G cell phone service providers. With Starlink already operating and competing services from Globalstar and Iridium, which use low orbits, and Amazon, AST Space Mobile, Link Global, and Telesat, all are planning similar services. The technology to handle data up and down links to low orbit satellites and hand the signal off between satellites is now well proven. But if the Satelliot system proves robust and cost effective, their ability to integrate seamlessly with terrestrial 5G networks with existing consumer hardware, SIM cards, and cellular service providers would represent a considerable market advantage over companies who require dedicated receivers. On the other hand, emerging commercial and industrial IoT applications may saturate the available bandwidth quickly, creating a two-tier satellite communications market of consumer voice and video service and a much larger data stream between devices. It's early in a rapidly emerging market, and it's unclear whether all the competing satellite systems will survive, but the relatively rapid orbital decay of low-orbit small satellites and the need to constantly replace them is paradoxically an opportunity for space data networks to constantly upgrade their service. For commercial users, the benefits are obvious. For consumers, the future may be low cost, no roaming charges, and personal data service providers that are global in scale. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.